What the heck is LeadPlayer? What does it do? And do you even need it? All that and more coming up on this episode of James Wedmore TV. All right, welcome to this full-blown review on LeadPlayer, a plugin or tool that I have been using for some time now and really excited to share with you. So we got a lot to cover. I'm gonna show you exactly what it is, how to use it, the results I've been getting, the proof, and then how you can be using it as well. Here we are over on my blog, and this is a quick demonstration of how it works. I think you're gonna start to see more and more sites using this. Okay, so I create a blog post about, well, this topic's on how to create backdrops for your videos, and I put a video on there. Now watch what happens when I play this video, or what anyone would experience when they play this video. Now, only after a few seconds of playing the video, it automatically pauses at its own, the screen darkens, and this little copy comes up the bottom that says, free report, the YouTube traffic report, discovered a simple three-step strategy for massive traffic, and then you can enter your email address to keep playing the video. Now, normally I have a skip button there, and I recommend you having that the same so people don't have to, you don't have to force people to do it. But this is essentially what LeadPlayer does. It takes your YouTube videos and creates a special function or trigger at any moment in the video so that an opt-in box or opt-in form can appear inside of your video. Now, there's also an option where you can have a little button appear inside the video and people can click that, which is very cool as well. But this, for me, is the number one thing. This is the best part. This is what I love about LeadPlayer. And I want to show you how I'm using this and the really cool results I've been getting. Okay, so the big 30,000 foot view is I have a blog. And on this blog, I'm sharing content at least once a week, giving video content, training tips, tutorials, and more to my readers. And they share that content using social media. I get traffic using SEO and more. You know, I email my list every week and I say, hey, here's my content for you. They watch my videos and they share it with their friends and new people find me. It gets indexed in the search engines. It gets indexed inside of YouTube, etc. And this is where the magic starts happening. They go on my blog, they watch the video, they opt in, and they go into my email list. So I'm using my blog, and you should be using it the same way, to build an email list, to grow your database of names and email addresses, whatever information you want to collect from them, okay? Obviously, I'm using LeadPlayer. You can actually see my name here as one of the people who's using LeadPlayer. Now, here's why I'm so excited about this. This is a screenshot of me segmenting my list based on where my opt-ins were coming from my blog. I wasn't getting too many leads from my blog, nothing too exciting, nothing to write home about. But you can actually see that the day, which was, what was that, October 17th of 2012, was the day I installed LeadPlayer. Now, there's obviously a huge jump that day because that was the day I emailed and made a big broadcast. But then what we did is we put LeadPlayer on every one of my past blog posts. Any other blog post that I had in the past that had a video on it all of a sudden had LeadPlayer on it. So any other past video that people were watching now had another way for people to opt in. And you can see what happened, not just on the 17th, but let's look at the 18th, let's look at the 20th, the 21st, the 22nd. These are about four times as many daily subscribers as before. What changed? What did I do differently? One thing. I added LeadPlayer to every video on my blog, all my past ones, and that made the difference. And it's still like that today, which is very, very exciting. This is why I love LeadPlayer, and I love recommending it because it works. So let me just show it to you one more time. You put up a video on your blog. At any moment, you can have the video pause, and people can type in just an email. You can have name and email. You can have that little option down there at the bottom to skip this step. But then there's also the ability to add a button that says click here to download the free report, the free gift, the free songs, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, so that's how it works. Let's go ahead and take a look now at the back end of LeadPlayer so you can see it in action a little bit. Okay, so LeadPlayer is a plugin. It's a WordPress plugin. So you have to have WordPress. You got to have your own website, and it's got to be run on WordPress. And this is what it's gonna look like once it's installed. Now, the default page shows a list of all my videos. As you can see, every single video I have has LeadPlayer installed on it. And we can go back and edit these and do anything we want. But we're going to go ahead and create a new video right now. And we do that by clicking Add New Video. And then we have all these little options here for the video title. We'll just do Test 1, Video Description, you know, whatever. We can. This, you want to use your keywords. And they're going to have little stuff here for you for SEO purposes. Now, you want to get the YouTube URL from your video. So we'll go ahead and do that now. I'll just go to my channel. We'll just pick one of my latest videos. And we will do, we'll do this one, which I've already done this one, but it's okay. And this is the URL you want to get. It should look like this, youtube.com/watch? with this ugly looking link at the end. Okay, you don't want the shortened URL that looks like this guy, the u2.be. You do not want that. You want the full one right there. Okay, so we just paste that YouTube URL in there. We can choose whatever dimension we want. It should be 16:9. Autoplay, yes or no. Most cases, you're going to want to keep that on a no because if it's on a video blog post, you don't want it to play until people click the play button. Show timeline, I like to keep that as yes. Enable HD, that's optional. That's up to you. It's going to slow it down a little bit, and there's some little notes here about that. So I just say no. And then you can create a custom thumbnail image. We're not going to do that for this one, so it'll just pull in the default thumbnail image from YouTube, but you can have a custom image here, which is really cool. Now, let's go ahead and save this video. And already, once it's finished saving, we can preview the video to see that it, you know, it works properly. So we scroll down here, we click preview video. No. Here's our video as it stands, and you know, we can just press play and it's gonna go. Nothing too exciting, different, or new has happened yet. So let's do the magic right now. We scroll up here and we have our opt-in and our call to action. We're just gonna play around with the opt-in. So we select this tab and we say include opt-in box, absolutely. You can ask for the name as well as the email. I have it on no. And then you can select which list you want to use. I use both AWeber and Infusionsoft. So in the default video settings and the player options, you can set that stuff up. Okay. Or you can create a new one right here. You can choose your copy, which I've already written it in, free report, the YouTube traffic report, discover the three simple steps. Now you can put this opt-in box at the beginning, the anywhere in the middle, or the end. So I did custom, and we'll just do 4 seconds. And then allow skipping, we wanna turn to yes. I really want you to do that, okay? Allow skipping. So now we click update video, and then we'll go ahead and preview it. And now you're gonna see our magic little video with its opt-in box. Let's go ahead and click play.
Hey guys, James Wedmore here, and today we're gonna be talking about how to find.
Now at exactly 4 seconds, the video paused and this popped up. Okay, now we're almost done. This is it in preview mode. Now I'm gonna show you really quickly how we can embed it. So I called this one test one, and this is really cool. You click the embed button, and if you're using LeadPlayer on the same WordPress website that you have this plugin installed, you just copy and paste this code. But if you want to use it outside of WordPress or on another blog or another website, this is really, really cool. You just click this link right here and grab this whole big code and paste that on any web page, on any HTML type page. And that is it. So there you have it, your full-blown review of LeadPlayer. My biggest pros with this is I love the design and the simplicity of it. It does one or two little functions, turning YouTube videos into opt-in forms, and it does them really, really well. It works. I've never had a glitch. I've never had an issue with this. And it's just very easy to use, right? And you kind of saw how easy it is to use. My biggest drawback is that there isn't too much customization within the design. Like, what if you wanted to have an image pop up with it? It's just like two lines of text and that's it. It'll work, but it would be really cool if we had a little bit more customization. Plus another con, which isn't a con for me, but might be for other people, is as far as I know, you can only use this for YouTube videos. You can't use it for like a Vimeo or any other like self-hosted video. It has to be a YouTube video. Okay, so those are the two big drawbacks, but I still use this and highly recommend it if you are doing YouTube videos or video blogging on your website. If you're not, don't bother. Price here is $147. You definitely want to get this little upgrade here because it removes the player branding And I just highly, highly recommend this. So there should be a link on your screen right now in order to sign up for LeadPlayer. That is my affiliate link. I do get a commission for this. I do not promote that many products at all, but the ones I do promote, I recommend because I use myself and they make me money. And you guys saw how I was able to do about a 400 to 500% increase on my list building efforts simply by adding this piece of software. And you know what? At the end of the day, this is the type of business we're in where we can be able to add a little automated piece of software, install it once, and then it works for us day in and day out without ever having to worry about it again. And that's what LeadPlayer does, and that's why it gets me so excited. And it should get you excited too. So I hope you enjoyed this review. You found it helpful. If not, well, that's okay. Let me know. Type in your questions below, your comments, and I'll do my best to answer them, maybe in another video or maybe just in the comment box. So thanks again for watching. I'll talk to you soon.